just wanted to join in the conversation about how did we get here in terms of the African American community, and is that the way African Americans are facing discrimination? I'm not gonna say it doesn't exist. It does very much exist. Their outcry could be very much justified. But I kind of want to take a look at how the African American community shot themselves in the foot. And it's an honest look at how African Americans are portraying themselves in the media just to make a buck. How they represent black men, how they represent black women, and even the value of who they are. And I just want to show a clip. It seems funny, but honestly, when you go through a lot of the movies, how are African Americans being represented? This is why we don't get the respect that we're supposed to be given, because our own people are creating caricatures of African American men and women to make money, putting onto a big screen for the world to see. And then you wonder why there is no respect in the black community when we are selling ourselves, selling caricatures of ourselves, calling it comedy, and then expecting respect from people who are not black. And so we're really looking at the wrong thing. And I think that the black community really needs to take a look inside. What are we even promoting? What are things that we're even like listening to? And I'm going to show a clip, and it is a comedy movie, but it just shows you how movies, the media is portraying blacks, and this is produced by blacks, right? And so I think there needs to be a change of how we represent the black community in media. And this is the clip from Don't Be a Menace. And the title is on YouTube called A Real Woman. And this is what they think a real woman is. Mind you, it's a comedy movie, but still you're using your platform to represent the black community in a caricature. And so we're supposed to be taken seriously as a black community when we're producing movies like this that has no regard for black women and has no value for black women or black male. We are shooting ourselves in the foot by the things that we produce, not by white men, but by black men and black women. For what? To make a buck. And now where has it gotten us? So here's a clip from Don't Be a Menace and A Real Woman. Now think about that. It's comedy. But when people see this, what these images are going to be working in their mind. Yeah, so Don't Be a Menace, produced by Marlon and Sean Wayans back in 1996. And it grossed $20 million in the box office. Let's play the clip here. Don't Be a Menace.
Don't steal my cars, nigga. Just hurry up,
get
my
cars.
Now
here we see the clip about blacks. Black brothers hanging out at a barbecue.
Hello.
So we see Sean Wayne looking like a fool, holding a 40, like a 40 in his hand.
Some of you can take home the stepmama. You know what I'm trying to say?
Say, let's get ourselves a real woman. What's a real woman? She's just down in that 40 like it's nothing.
Real woman. I try. You see that bitch over there?
Called her a profanity.
Now that's a lady.
Bet you I can get her number. Now it's a competition. And for what? To marry her? To love her? To care of her? No. Just to get in bed with her. Here he comes.
Break yourself!
puts a gun to her head. Give me your phone number.
Come on.
So we're only promoting violence and a really negative image about the black community.
I'm giving you a call about 5.
Got her phone number, puts a gun to her head.
Sit, all right?
Yeah.
All right, sweetheart. Take care of yourself, all right?
To celebrating that. Silly. For what? Why we represent our culture like that? It's completely foolishness. Look at the other brother trying to hang out with his other girl to get her phone number.
Hey,
now watch this.
Please.
Hey, mister.
What's up, little man?
Are you just trying to get some to my mom?
The boy knows his mom is not faithful.
Nah, little man. Actually, I'm
give me a dollar and leave you alone from bothering my mom. This boy's about to creep into. See the respect of the mom? A dollar
cute
bill.
Little kid. Oh, by the way, my name is Astra.
My name is Dashiki. That's Swahili for doggy style.
Yep.
Ooh, that's
very
great.
Sexualized.
Those
talking.
Are my kids.
These are all her kids from different dads.
Hello, everybody.
Now, children, what do you say when you meet a nice man?
Are you my daddy?
So when you see a nice man, what do you say to him? Are you my daddy? This is just an example of how the black community is portraying themselves in movies. It shouldn't be like that. And so we wonder why we're getting laughed at. We wonder why there's no respect. It's because our own people are selling the black culture as a caricature to make money. To make what? $20 million in your pocket? And you're only propagating such a negative view of the African American community. You think it's just a comedy? Well, when you keep producing movie after movie after movie, representing black women as having no value, as having showing black men is being belligerent and violent and abusive. And then you see a lot of little children having like different kids, same mother but different dads. What are you promoting? Are you promoting for us to be respected, or are you promoting the world for us to laugh at the black community? This is creating more harm than good. And so we really have to examine ourselves. Are we going to keep producing movies that is going to represent black men and black women in this way? And so this is only one small example. And when we look at other black figures in Hollywood and in media, and you start to look at what type of person they're portraying in the movies, well, ask yourself, this is why the black community is in this condition. And so we have to take a look at ourselves, not point the fingers to others. And this, for example, this is an example of Don't Be a Menace, was produced by two black men, not by white men, by two black men that thought it's funny to make black women and black men into a caricature. And I think it's time to stop.
I want to do it because it's fun. It's fun to do bad things, to drive into a car.
But did you know that you could perhaps kill somebody?
Yes, but I wanted to do hood rat stuff with my friend.